this is Lenny and Belisi, or Belisi and Lenny, rather, doing Unit 8 of Hansen and Quinn. And the first thing that we want to talk about is, what is a participle? Okay, welcome to the wonderful world of participles, as Belisi has put it. These are amazing, an amazing aspect of this language. We don't have anything as rich, as fully developed, and as expressive a system of participles as Greek does. So we're going to learn about how they, what the forms are today in this lesson. Basically, that's it, and a very simple amount of things about what they do. They're extremely flexible and complicated. They have all kinds of functions in real Greek, and we're just going to scratch the surface before the end of the semester, but it's important to do that. It's also a way of reviewing the whole verbal system, okay? So it has multiple benefits. All right, so first of all, let's talk about English. What is a participle? And the Latin word participle comes from a Latin, I mean, the English word participle comes from a Latin word, an adjective, parti, keps. The parti part is not about parties, but part. And keps comes from the Latin verb capio, that means to take. So it means an adjective meaning take. It's an adjective meaning taking part in or sharing. We could put a comma after the in there. Okay. If we go to the next screen, we learn that the Greek word for participle is just a noun, metoche. Okay. It's the action noun from a verb that means to share, and it means sharing, the process of sharing, the noun, the gerund, sharing. Okay, so the question is, what does it have to do with participles, and why, what do participles share, why do they have this name? And the answer is, da-dum.
Blade.
There we go. Here's what they share in. The two things they share in are adjectiveness and verbness, okay? And these are properties that are crucial to them. So when we come to the forms, you will see that Greek participles have the aspect and the voice of verb forms, but they have gender, number, and case, like adjectives. So it's literally the case that they are they're like centaurs, okay? They're composed of two different things, adjectives and verbs. So there's the definition of a participle. It's fundamentally an adjective, okay, derived from a verb that has the properties of both, okay? But it's important to think of the adjectiveness as the primary aspect, as the thing, if you're thinking of shading or backgrounding, the adjectiveness is in front and the verbness is a little bit beneath the surface. But we can give you an example, and you'll see that this is the thing that adjectives do in English as much as they do in Greek. Okay, so here's our choice. We choose the word sharing, the participle sharing, that is the adjective sharing, as in the sentence, the man sharing his sandwich with his dog went hungry. Okay, in that sentence, the word sharing is an adjective modifying man, right? The man sharing his sandwich. But notice, it's not just any old thing, right? It's got a direct object, sharing his sandwich. The sandwich is the direct object of the verb that's embedded in the participle sharing. Okay? So here's a dramatic way of showing you that participles have both nounness, or adjectiveness rather, and verbness, okay? Notice, don't get confused, because in English, it has nothing to do with Greek. In Greek, there's no such complication. That ing suffix that you have in sharing does more than one thing. It is the suffix to produce a gerund, which is a noun derived from a verb. That is not a participle. So sharing your sandwich with your dog is unsanitary. Sharing there is the subject of the sentence. It too has a direct object, sandwich, but it's not a participle because it's a noun and it's not an adjective.
They learned one way to do that already, right? Mm-hmm. The sharing noun.
Yep, exactly. The sharing noun.
Infinitive.
Exactly. But you also need to know what you do already know about adjectives in Greek is that adjectives can become nouns if you treat them in the right way, right? Mm-hmm. So we have to be prepared that there are certain ways in which adjectives can function like nouns. Okay, we'll learn that. All right.
Bye.